Hey, what's up, everybody? So as you can see, I'm in my car. This is our night to order out. So I'm ordering out at a local restaurant, support the local businesses, and we want to try to do that each week because I know it's a tough time for everybody, and we want to make sure we support our, especially our local businesses, so they can just keep going. And but one of the things I wanted to share and just kind of throw this question out there is like, what irrational, whether they're fears or hatreds, do you have? So I have a confession to make. I have this irrational, I know it's irrational. I completely admit that it's irrational. I have this irrational hatred of wind. I cannot stand it. I was trying to think of good things that wind does, and I was like, I told Allie today, I was like, name five good things that wind does. And you know, she starts listing things, and I had a rebuttal for each one, but I just have this irrational hatred of wind because, man, it just blows everything everywhere. It blows, like, I had to pick up recycling so many times today because it blew over the whole bin and all this stuff. And I'm just like, oh, you've got to be kidding me. And, you know, it got me thinking about this because in a time where there's this, in a time where, you know, your world is kind of turned upside down like everybody's is right now, we can develop these irrational hatreds and frustrations, and they can carry over when things do start going back to whatever normal is after this is over. And you know, I've been thinking about a lot and praying often for our, you know, government leaders, because they have decisions to make that are very tough decisions to make. And I know some states are starting to saying they're going to open back up this week and even next week, and you know, there's people that are you know, criticizing them for that and this and that. So as followers of Jesus, I want to make sure that we're not carrying over any irrational frustrations or hatreds or even fears when whatever happens. You know, if we have to stay shut down for longer or if we get to open up soon, whatever that may be, let's make sure that we are, as followers of Jesus, people of grace and peace and love. And one of the things I think is a good challenge for ourselves is to develop new rhythms and rhythms of grace, as some Christians call them. And those rhythms of grace, and what I mean by that is just whatever those things are that lets you unplug from reality and unplug from the world around you, do those things. If you start feeling frustrated and you start feeling, you know, I talked about frustrations yesterday in the video. But if you're feeling yourself frustrated and you're feeling yourself like wallowing in that kind of depressed state and frustrated state and anxious state and stressed state and even the angry state, find those rhythms of grace. If you don't have any, develop some. You know, Allie has developed, she's always been a very artistic person. And so she ordered some watercolors and she started doing watercolor paintings, and that's kind of her thing now. And she's just like finding time to do that. And it's, you know, it's helping her. And then, you know, Shepherd, I was 9, you know, he developed a knack for drawing, and it's great. You know, he's able to draw and, you know, express things through that. And it's awesome. So we all have our different things that we can escape to. Mine's reading. Mine's, you know, just kind of unplugging from that. And, you know, if it could just be mindless, it doesn't have to be anything super serious or important. It could be something that allows you to step away and unplug. So find those rhythms of grace. And in those times of rhythms of grace, in those times of stepping away from everything, you know, make sure you're spending time with God. Make sure you're spending time with Him. And again, tell Him your frustrations, tell Him your stress, tell Him your irrational hatreds and fears. And then the God of all grace and the God of all peace will rain down upon you and give you that peace that you need, that we all need to sustain us and help us through whatever lies ahead, whatever road that God has taken us on in the coming weeks and months ahead. And so let's find rest for our souls in Jesus, and He will help us through this. So let's not carry over any kind of rational fears or hatreds as things progress. Let's rest in Jesus. Hope to see you soon.